Hi there. So now we are going to talk about the Marina Bay Sands, which is actually a luxurious hotel, which is located in Singapore. It's located in the central business district area, which is actually the most central area where it's very convenient to clients who are here for holiday and also for business related purposes. So here we can see the slides. So going back up again. So this is Marina Bay Sands. As you can see, it's actually a very new and fabulous hotel. Secondly, we're going to talk about some of the what this is actually a quote that is talked about in about Marina Bay Sands, which is actually it stands out for not just being tall, but having a distinctive feature about the building, which is actually it has three different tall complexes for the building, and each of these complexes actually holds hotels and also integrated resorts where there's a Sands Convention Center. So this is actually a quote by building. So now here we have actually this, as well as you can see over here, is the whole of the Marina Bay Sands and its integrated complexes. As you can see from the on the back, we can actually see the full Marina Bay Sands and the Sky Park. In the front, we have the casino and the theaters and the museum. And on your left and on your right side, you can actually see the Sands Expo and Convention Center and the shops and dining areas. And lastly, we also have the Crystal Pavilion, the Events Plaza, and the and some other shops. They are situated near the waterfront area. So the waterfront area is very popular for joggers and also for beautiful scenic views of the Marina Bay skyline. So here we have some of the facts about Marina Bay Sands. So for example, Marina Bay Sands is actually a 99,000 square meters high density complex, and it's also an integrated resort, and it also is located in the south on a land which is reclaimed from the sea in the late 1970s, and it's also very popular for casino guests and also for hotel guests who are coming from afar, because it's actually an integrated resort together with the convention center. So it actually has a lot of convenience. It offers a lot of convenience, and it also offers beautiful scenic views of the skyline. And one of its distinctive feature, which is not featured here, is actually the swimming pool, which is it actually features a infinity pool where visitors can use in their free time. So we're going to talk about firstly we're going to address what is SWOT analysis. So SWOT analysis actually it stands for acronym Strength, Weakness, Opportunities and Threats. Strengths are characteristics of business that gives it advantage. Weaknesses are the opposite of it. Opportunities are what are some of the elements in which the business is able to exploit. And threats are some of the elements in which that could threaten the business. As you can see, it's over here, SWOT analysis. So what are some of the strengths in which we have done? Firstly, it actually offers a highly customized and highly big casino. And this casino is over 15,000 square meters and over 4 floors. And it's one of the world's largest. It has one of the world's largest chandlers in the casino. So this is the picture of the casino. And this is one of the strengths in which the hotel is able to offer, in that its casino is quite a huge casino, and it's very large, and it has many different games that's available in the casino. These are some of the points of the casino in which we actually is able to attract large group of tourists, and it's a large source of revenue. And since gambling is illegal in Singapore, except by at two different areas, which is Marina Bay Sands and Resorts World Sentosa, so that's why it actually offers a very lucrative area for where the gen where these casinos are able to generate much needed revenue. So secondly, what's some of the second strength is that it has a very good Singapore has a very good gambling tax rate. So as you can see, the tax rate on Singapore is about 12%, whereas for other countries it's about 40% in Macau. So because of such good revenue tax rates, casinos are able to profit much from these casinos, and also be able to that and that's the reason why they are able to it's a very profitable venture in Singapore. Another thing is that in Singapore there's a dualization of the casinos and the only two big major players are Resorts World Sentosa and Marina Bay Sands. As such, it actually owns a monopoly share of the market, duopoly share of the market, and it actually it is a very lucrative business. So as you can see, here we have the summary of the strengths over here, casino, and the favorable tax rates and the duopolization of the market. So now we'll talk some of the weaknesses. So firstly, first weaknesses is that it's affected very strongly by tourism decline. From these statistics that we have found over here, we can actually see that the VIP rates has dropped year on year from financial year 2015 of 12% to 8% for financial year 2016. This is because of, why is that so? So this is because of the tourism growth, which actually tourism actually fell from in 10% in 2015. As such, the VIPs, they do not come here anymore, and because due to the tourism fell sectors and the growth slowing in China, that's why therefore our VIP revenues actually dropped. So it's very strongly affected by external factors. Secondly, we also face resource constraints. So in many cases, there's a limited number of hotel beds and there's a limited number of retail outlets that you can lease out to the pub to companies to start their own businesses. As such, these are some of the weaknesses of this due to the spatial constraints in Singapore, these are some of the weaknesses of Marina Bay Sands. So as you can see, here's the summary again. It's affected by tourism decline and resource constraints. Now we'll go on to opportunities. So as you can see from the results over here, we actually have high growth expected from Chinese tourists. In the late 2020s, we expect 200 million Chinese tourists to travel outside of China for holidays and for to and be able to generate revenue for the for their different countries in which they are going to. So Chinese tourism is expected to increase annually 10% from 2017, and this is a source that's formed from Krinsky and Ernst & Young. So, and also another opportunity is that we have actually the sale of non-core assets. Marina Bay Sands is intending to sell the non-core assets, such as their retail arm, to finance other projects. And as such, right, they are able to reduce the debt that they bore by building this infrastructure of the Marina Bay Sands projects, and they're able to gain some source of money for external other projects. So as you can see, here's our summary table again, that this is a summary of the strengths, weakness, and opportunities for the Marina Bay Sands. So now we're going to talk about threats. There's a governmental regulations is one of the possible threat, is that there could be a limitation of visas and by the Chinese government, and also possibility of pressures for the for to increase the gambling tax rate, which is currently the one of the lowest in Asia. For Singapore. So there may be outside pressures for them to increase the tax rate from 12% to 39.5%, which is what the rate is in Macau. As such, as such, the possible revenue stream for Marina Bay Sands could fall dramatically due to the increased tax rates. Another threat is the strong industrial rivalry. Here we have actually what we can see is actually Resorts World Sentosa. They are also another platform where they have integrated resorts and also hotels, and also attractions such as Universal World Studios. So as such, they actually form a very strong rival of Marina Bay Sands and could actually see some of the potential streams of revenue for Marina Bay Sands. So here we can see the food finalized table for the SWOT analysis of Marina Bay Sands. So what we actually propose is actually to use some information technology solutions to improve the advantages and competitive advantages of Marina Bay Sands. So what we propose are three different streams. Firstly is the property management system, dynamic pricing, and cost reduction measures. So onto property management systems, we propose that we use a central management system that controls all operations. So this includes technical orders and also F&B and room sets. By requiring managers to input all their events to the into the program. So through this program, we're able to reduce double bookings and also backlog orders, and to optimize resources and constraints and land space and exhibition usage. And this is when this not only this system we're able to do that, but you'll also be able to understand what customers are preferences are, and also to be able to provide a better service to the customers whenever they come back to Marina Bay Sands for their ideas. So secondly, we're going to talk about dynamic pricing mechanism. So dynamic pricing mechanism is actually talks about how we're able to use dynamic pricing for hotel room rates. So dynamic pricing is able we are for such as to use a proprietary dynamic pricing mechanism, or to use industrial users such as Sabre, to allow the pricing of each hotel rooms to be able to price them according to seasons, peak seasons, or daily basis. So they are able to help to minimize the maximize the occupancy rate of hotels and be able to maximize their revenues. And lastly, the cost cutting measures. We propose a green technology to reduce the cost. So for example, we can actually use the EcoMode systems to maintain the air conditioning temperatures, motion sensors for hotel rooms, and deployment of light dimmers to reduce intensity of the light room lighting. As you can see from the pictures below, these are some of the examples on which we have proposed to reduce the cost and to maximize the revenue for Marina Bay Sands. So these are the summary reasons in which we have identified and what we can work on for using ICT, information and communications technology, to improve this the advantages and to promote competitive advantages for Marina Bay Sands. So as you can see, we have come to the end of this presentation, and Marina Bay Sands is indeed a luxury hotel and is able to maximize it's able to improve on its efficiencies using new technologies. So these are some of the credits. Thank you very much for hearing this presentation.